Normal pressure hydrocephalus, or NPH, is a form of hydrocephalus that affects older adults. Sometimes the cause of NPH is known and can include head trauma or a brain tumor, but most often the cause is not known. Some of the symptoms of NPH include issues with walking or balance, impaired bladder control, and mild dementia that can be characterized by loss of interest in daily activities, forgetfulness, short-term memory loss, or difficulty dealing with regular tasks.
Sometimes older people or older patients with normal pressure hydrocephalus will have a triad or three symptoms present all at the same time. The three symptoms that we see with normal pressure hydrocephalus in adults are gait dysfunction, urinary incontinence, and problems with memory.
To diagnose NPH, a neurologist will evaluate these symptoms and use an MRI or CT to check for enlarged ventricles. The process of diagnosing NPH can be difficult and often frustrating for families. The symptoms are typical of other conditions that afflict people over 60 years old. In fact, 250,000 Americans with dementia, Alzheimer's, or Parkinson's may actually have NPH. That's why it's important for you and your family to ask your doctor any questions you may have about NPH and how it's treated. There are a number of tests your neurologist can administer to try and predict shunt responsiveness or determine shunt pressure prior to surgery. There are a few ways to predict whether a shunt surgery may be more successful. Factors include whether or not the onset of walking and balance issues was the first, most prominent symptom, if there is a known cause for your NPH, such as trauma or hemorrhage, if scans show the ventricular size to be disproportionately larger than the CSF in the space, if your doctor has removed spinal fluid through a lumbar puncture or catheter, and if there is minimal evidence of disease in the small blood vessels nourishing the brain. Because some people with NPH have additional medical or neurological problems, it is important to discuss the expectations of shunt surgery with your neurosurgeon. People who have abnormal bleeding tendencies or take medication that affect bleeding should talk with their medical team about any special precautions before the procedure. Although shunt surgery is a relatively simple neurosurgical procedure, the decision to undergo it should not be taken lightly. The treatment of NPH carries greater risks than the treatment of children with hydrocephalus. The potential complications of shunt surgery include those related to the actual operation and those that may occur years later. One of the most common problems is the shunt system becomes clogged. A shunt obstruction is typically suspected when the original symptoms reappear. Fortunately, shunt obstruction in NPH is usually easily fixed and rarely results in serious problems, although future surgery may be necessary. Other potential complications include shunt malfunction, infection, bleeding in the brain, seizure, a blood clot, or a reaction to the implanted shunt materials. Fortunately, these complications are uncommon and can be managed successfully in almost all cases, although some may require additional surgery. Be sure to discuss these risks and any other questions you may have with your neurosurgeon prior to surgery. Hydrocephalus is often called water on the brain. That water is actually the cerebrospinal fluid, or CSF, that we discussed earlier. To remove the CSF, the surgeon implants a flexible tube with a valve mechanism called a shunt system. An incision is made on the scalp, and a small hole is made in the skull to allow the ventricular catheter or tube to be placed in the ventricle. This allows the CSF to drain away from the brain. Another incision is made in the abdomen, and the valve unit and associated tubing is passed under the skin between the scalp and the abdominal incision. The surgeon connects the valve unit to the ventricular catheter and then places the end of the tube or peritoneal catheter into the peritoneal cavity or the abdominal area. Once the shunt system is in place, the one-way valve will automatically open to drain excess CSF into the abdomen whenever the pressure in the skull exceeds the valve setting. The procedure typically lasts a couple of hours. Following shunt surgery, you'll be moved from the operating room to the recovery room, where a nurse will check your blood pressure, heart rate, breathing rate, temperature, and brain function by asking you to move your arms, legs, fingers, and toes. When you wake up from surgery, you will likely feel weak and tired. This is natural as the body starts to heal. A nurse will encourage you to get up and move soon after surgery to help speed the recovery process. Once you start to feel better, you'll be allowed to do more things, such as eat solid foods and use the bathroom by yourself. You'll be discharged from the hospital once your neurosurgeon feels you're ready, usually about a day or two after surgery. Your doctor will give you instructions for recovering at home. Keep in mind that once you are home from the hospital, you still need to rest. During this time, you should concentrate on building up your strength so you can return to normal activities. This may take a few weeks. Your doctor will let you know when it's okay to return to your regular routine. Hydrocephalus symptoms may improve within days of shunt surgery or may take weeks or months to subside. There is no way to predict how fast or to what extent the improvement will occur. For patients who do improve, changes are seen in the first week in most cases. The improvement may range from mild to dramatic, but we cannot predict how long the improvement will last. Some patients seem to reach a plateau, while others improve for months, but then seem to decline again. Typically, the more symptoms a patient has due to NPH, rather than associated conditions like Alzheimer's and arthritis, the greater likelihood of a successful recovery. Generally, patients with an implanted shunt system can resume daily activities, with the exception of those that are intense physically. Your doctor will discuss any restrictions with you. Most patients with NPH can look forward to a normal future. Shunts are expected to perform reliably over a long period of time. However, because NPH is an ongoing condition, you'll need to continue long-term care with your doctor. Occasionally, shunt systems require revisions. A revision is a surgical procedure to modify, repair, or replace a shunt system due to complications or if a patient's condition has changed. You and your family should become familiar with the signs and symptoms of shunt malfunction. These include headache, vision problems, irritability, tiredness, personality changes, loss of coordination, difficulty waking or staying awake, mild dementia, and incontinence. Although it's hard to predict the outcome and improvements a shunt procedure will produce, please know that NPH is not a hopeless condition. Advances in shunt technology and surgical techniques are continually being introduced and developed.